Hi guys, and welcome back to another episode of my new Manchester United career mode. I'm currently, as you can see, selecting the team. I think today's game is Brighton, and it's at Old Trafford. We've just come off the European, not European, bloody hell, Europa League game against Dynamo Bucharesti, where we won that. I think it was 2-1. So we're keeping the Europa League campaign alive just at the moment. I think we need to win the next two games to even qualify, so we're still in a uphill battle. And that's why so many of my players are tired, as you can see. All the players who played in our last game are knackered. I think it was literally like 2 days ago. And it just highlights the lack of squad depth in this team. Look at my bench. Greenwood can be an amazing player, but he's still only, well, 17 and 72 overall. Pereira, I don't really rate at all. He's not too bad on FIFA as a squad player, but I'm bringing Laid in because Chong was tired and he can play wide Laid, so depending on how the game goes, I could give him a go. Levitt, not just because I'm Welsh, but without really playing, he's gone up two, so I've stuck him in, because with game time he could really grow and he's only 18. Can play anywhere in the midfield. So I've stuck him in. Fosu Mensah, one of my favourite players in career mode. Last couple of seasons, because he can play pretty much anywhere. Bernard is still in the bench and Romero is my backup keeper. And as you can see, De Gea, Wan-Bissaka, Transebi, Lindelof, Shaw, Pogba, Fred, Mata in the 10, who's been very good, even though I don't rate him too much. James and Martial, slight fatigue issues, but they'll be fine. And the same with Rashford. And De Gea, captain. I'll show you the league table now. So we are still quite some distance off top four. Obviously, Champions League football is the minimum requirement I set for myself, and both are in jeopardy at the moment. As you can see, we're seventh at the moment. Arsenal were currently in fourth on 26, so 8 points off top four. We have been inconsistent, but lately we've been the opposite. We've been pretty consistent with our results. I'll quickly show you. 3-1 against Dynamo. 2-1 against Bournemouth. Cup games don't matter too much, but 2-1. We beat Norwich 3-0. Dynamo 4-1. We lost against Liverpool 4-2. But beat Newcastle 1-0. Got smashed by AZ. Then the league, we've been pretty consistent. Oh, maybe not then. I thought we were better than that. Lost 3-1 to Arsenal. 3-0. Yeah, still a bit of a mixed bag. I thought we were a bit more consistent than that, but I think it's because it's been a lot of games and I've been winning cup games in between. So 1-0 there. We lost to Liverpool. So Norwich we won. Oh my God. We've won two games on the bounce in the league and I'm bumping on about consistency. Shut up, Rod. You're talking shite. This is something I seen earlier as well, which made me laugh a bit. Players leaving on international duty. Oh, it's changed now. How could it change? I uploaded it earlier and I don't know what it was, but on the news feed and when I went onto the squad hub, the players were like really red and like discolored, so I had to restart it. And the only English player to get called up was Lingard. Yet now, having restarted the game, Lingard's nowhere to be seen. And Wan-Bissaka, Maguire and Luke Shaw go in. No Dan James for Wales or anything like that. Weird. Just checking the calendar quickly a second. Yeah, after this we go. Well, as you've just seen, it's the international break, so let's get into it. You're not cheating by having a green kit, Brighton. You can piss off. Blending in with the turf. I'm not having that, lads. Hey Laps, what's happening? Fancy verse, bro. How you doing, mate?
And welcome everyone to England's northwest. The action soon to get underway here at Old Trafford.
What was I saying? A must-win game again,
Ray,
guys.
Joined for commentary by
8 points off top four.
Lee Dixon, and it's all about action from the Premier League.
No, it's still
in this
only
case. It is Manchester
December,
United
but
facing Brighton and Hove Albion.
Yeah, thank you, Derek.
I've had a nice little run of fixtures here against teams who I should be beating. So
some entertaining football. Hopefully, we'll get that.
Enjoy
the game. The video analysis
want to know the manual settings and sliders I use? Go and watch episode one, all is explained in there. It's pretty much full manual, other than shooting, which is semi-manual, but
that's the case today.
It's pretty much full manual.
Anthony Martial. Here's Luke
Shaw.
Sure,
needed some encouragement to run forward, but eventually does. Now we just fly in, go on.
Targets to aim at.
Oh, James up, matter.
And he's clear as lines.
Fred, get to that boy. Yes, nice.
Wan-Bissaka.
Plenty of one person in.
In
the
middle.
Good pressure. Come on, the boys.
Fred with it. James.
Sure, Wan-Bissaka's living offside, but there.
This is the team Manchester United
James.
Will go with.
Mbisaka's well
good
up the pitch,
display.
And Fred can't catch him.
Useful cross towards
he
the near post. Not all that hard to deal with crosses like
steady
that.
Steady on, Dave. Steady on, sir.
And the team selected for Brighton and Hove Albion. In goal for this match, it's Matthew Ryan.
Funny part, but he really needs to step up. He's
Lewis
been quite poor, to be
Dunk
honest,
defense,
considering he's my
idea is to have
best outfield player.
Up there, trying to
that's
pose
possible.
Problems for the opposition.
Gosh, oh, smashes it in. Dan James has been probably my best player. As soon as I say aye, he bloody misplaces a pass. Well done, Dan. Beating you up.
Dunk on the ball.
And then you tuck me up like that.
Fancy
tugging up a fellow
hard.
Taff like that.
Great strong tackle. Throw in
bloody disgusting.
Well, as we glance at the table,
yeah, I checked
really
his stats before the game
be
and he's been phenomenal.
Highly competitive,
I mean, he's got like 7 assists.
Yeah, plenty
and maybe
of
4 or 5 goals.
Hoping to lift the trophy at the end of the season. I think
God.
Most fans, Derek, particularly the neutrals like me and you, love a close race. Nobody likes to see a team run away with it.
Up.
And the danger clear. Juan Mata. Here is Fred.
And James, go! Make a run! That's up.
Oh.
We're not gonna catch him.
Big chance it is.
Oh shit! Pass. I put more power on the pass than that. Trust me, I held it down quite a lot then.
Fred with
inconsistency
it.
On the power of the passes. So annoying.
Here is Fred. Here's Axel Tuanzebe. Wan-Bissaka.
Should have been 1-0.
Looking confident with the ball at his feet.
Whoa. See, even in that pass, he bloody launches into Fred when I hardly held it down. Inconsistency. Oh, what a ball.
Taking care of business defensively here.
Get with Luke. Run with it, Luke.
Shaw. Now he must favour the cross. Now they get high marks for that move.
It's like a bloody tank when he's running at people.
Montoya. Scalotto in possession.
Martial needs to up his game a little bit as well.
Stevens.
I've said in a couple of other videos,
now
I'm not convinced by Mark. I don't know what it is about
Mopay.
Him. On FIFA, I'm not very convinced
tackle, really.
By him.
And now a throw in.
I don't know what it is. When I play him at wide, I'm like, is he really a winger? And then when I play him up front,
Stevens.
You know, in the nine, is he really a nine?
Now in possession, Trossard, Richards. Dale
I have the
Stevens
same sort of feeling
it.
About Rashford as well, mate.
Still on level
when
terms,
I play him up front, I'm like, is he really
nicely.
A nine? Oh! Well done, Lindelof. Excellent interception.
Sure.
Some places you know we're number 9, don't you? Like Lukaku, 9. Martinez for Inter, 9.
Wonderful
Harry Kane, 9.
And a throw-in coming up.
Tammy Abraham, 9. Firmino 9.
Setting off perhaps a Rashford is like,
what is he?
Aaron Wan-Bissaka.
Obviously plays better down the left, but... Oh, Wan-Bissaka, man,
he does know how to do is shield the ball.
Well, it's Manchester like
United
that.
On the back of what was a season of ups and downs when Ole Gunnar Solskjaer moved into the job, replacing Jose Mourinho. They went 12 league games unbeaten, but they couldn't really keep that flame burning, Lee.
Well, there's no doubt when he went into the job, he did have an effect. The bounce effect
Luke
of the
Shaw's
new manager,
good start.
Plus Solskjaer's a Man United man through and through. But the players' form dropped off, and some of those players have paid the price.
Oh, Mata! Why does Mata not go towards the ball? That cross was aimed at Mata. When he had to run onto it.
Might be able to produce from this position.
Nice done, James.
And Mata, useful ball towards the back post this time. A very effective clearance. Scalotto.
Guys, I don't know whether Pogba's going to be in my second season. One, because I put a stipulation in place where if I don't qualify for Europe, I've got to sell him anyway. But even if I do qualify for Europe, I don't know whether I'm going to keep him. Because of the ongoing issues in real life.
Bernardo.
And the fact that I don't think he wants to be at United anymore.
Now in possession, Trossard. Crossed accurately towards the far post.
I don't know if I really want him in my second season.
Pogba.
He hasn't been playing great anyway.
Martial. Rashford.
Players are getting tackled like far too easily.
Bernardo on
the shoulder and they didn't barge the ball every time.
Stevens.
Well,
read it superbly to take back possession.
Oh, fuck off, Wan-Bissaka! Terrible pass again.
Eve Bissouma has it.
As good as Matt has been, is such a bit different from
Scalotto in possession.
Playing
on and on he goes.
Like Madison there, which I did Montoya. In my first career mode.
Teammates could potentially join in.
I love Montoya Madison on FIFA. I will be trying to sign him again.
Bender got the last touch. That'll be a corner. Keen to take it short here.
Turned in.
Must score.
Out.
Not all that convincing defensively.
Clear it, Rashford. Bloody hell, man.
Martial.
Rashford, go on. Oh, Fred, what a fucking pass.
And the alarm bells are ringing.
What a goal that is. What a pass by Fred. Manual settings as well, guys. That was all manual. Which is why I'm wanking over it, nearly. What a pass from Fred. Lovely run by Rashford as well. A nice finish, but what a pass from Fred.
Well, the manager knows.
Yes, I'm watching it again. Don't like it. Tough shit. Look at this. Oh. My hand is going straight down my pants now, boys. Let's watch in real time. Martial to Fred. Look at Rashford gone. Brilliant run. In between the two defenders. We're not catching him. And the composure to just roll it in. Beautiful. What a pass from Fred.
Goal. He also knows that you're at your most vulnerable just after you've scored.
So nice to see my forward actually making a run. Instead of just standing still. Well done, Rashi, boy. The mid-runs like that. And with players like Fred and Pogba behind. And even Mata. They will find you, like. And with Rashford's pace, who's going to catch him?
It is on the must-visit list of most football fans. Old Trafford, the theatre of dreams, but often a chamber of horrors for away sides, Lee.
Well, it's an awesome, classic, old English stadium, and I used to love playing here. Had a few good hidings here, I must say, but it was one of those grounds
Wan-Bissaka's been poor.
Coming to.
Well, saying that, Bart-Luke Shaw, who's been quite consistent lately. All my fullbacks have been pretty shit so far this season. Now, Brandon Williams is young, but on my ever career mode, he was immense. He's been... He's been quite poor. Darlow's been poor. Wan-Bissaka's been very shaky at the start. That said, Luke Shaw's been quite decent. I found that a bit weird. One thread. Oh, boys, this football! Oh! This football is beautiful! What a move again! Tanzebe. That's what I love about Tanzebe, the pace. That was Maguire, I think that Brighton guy would have been in. I do like my centre bats to be fast.
Pogba. Lindelof now.
Playing some lovely football, lads. And girls, if there's any girls watching. Mata, don't lose that. Don't lose it. Yes. Mata, you... you trying to lose it? Or just wind me up? Pogba. First time? Hit that with his left. Fred been brilliant. Fair play to him. Really good.
Here is Fred.
Oh, look at that. His passing is sexual.
Couldn't keep it. Duffy.
Only 1-0, but playing some beautiful football. The concern is we're only winning 1-0.
Well, Derek, it certainly was a good
as far as how we play it. Really good. Again, Pogba, quiet. But Fred is outshining Pogba consistently. That's why I really don't know if I'm gonna keep him. Plus, in January, I'm one of the other stipulations I've given myself is I can, if I want to, it's up to me. I can sign Bruno and Igalo. Not that I'm trying to keep the career mode exactly the same as real life, but I just want to do the first season with the exact same options as what Ollie's got. So if I want to sign Bruno and Igalo in January, I will do. Obviously, Igalo will only be a loan, but Bruno would be permanent, and I'm definitely signing Bruno. So if I bring Bruno in and he starts performing well and, you know, playing better than Pogba, I wouldn't be afraid to drop Pogba to the bench. I'll play whoever's playing better. And it's a very good chance Bruno could come in and plenty hit the ground running and take Pogba's place. So far, as the second if that's begins, the case, very likely Pogba could go in the summer, regardless of whether I qualify for the Champions League or not.
Richards.
It's sad because I do really like Pogba, especially on FIFA, but it's fine. In FIFA 20, he's not that good to play as.
Now, will they be able to play it in behind the defense?
Or maybe it's that he's not as good
Bernardo
in the sort of holding position. He needs to be more in the 10, but
that move looked as though it had genuine potential, but it's
with the players I got, I need to play him there. That's like the 7 cover quality. Lindelof. Some of Lindelof's passing from the back is Martial. Really nice. That's crap, Martial. I knew as soon as I pressed triangle in. Crap pass. Anthony.
Martial.
Mata.
Contribution, but what next?
Fred, busy B. Fred.
More Premier League action coming up for you here on EA TV.
He's been phenomenal, hasn't he?
Facing Sheffield United.
Yeah, one Martial.
Be a great atmosphere there. It's one I would be tuning in for if I wasn't there with you.
Oh, boys, Fred is our Scholes in disguise.
Running with the ball confidently.
James,
it did appear that they might be onto something, but not so. Just a quick reminder, we have more action from the Premier League coming your way. It's Brighton and Hove Albion taking on Leicester City.
Yeah, really looking forward to it. Always a great atmosphere in that stadium. It should be a really entertaining match.
Hold up.
A And he takes on
the shot. Rashford out the
and
way.
The danger cleared.
Oof. What control from Fred. Fonzabi launched that at him.
Here's Luke Shaw.
Fred took it down like bloody...
perhaps a little bit too much here.
Prime Zidane.
Paul Pogba. Aaron Wan-Bissaka.
Ah, see, Wan-Bissaka again.
Throw in here.
I'm obviously going to stick with him because he's a quality player and he's only young, but...
where a goal has been scored, Alan McInally.
It's a goal for Manchester City.
He's been really poor.
It's been scored by Kevin De Bruyne.
Oh, Liverpool, Man City. And Man City have taken the lead. Wow. At Anfield as well.
And swiveled to dispatch a shot.
This day's at Abbey would overtake Liverpool at the top.
1-0. Regular
update. I totally forgot they were playing each other. Kevin De Bruyne as well. Prince Harry.
It's all about translating threats.
An absolute nightmare
goals.
To play against on FIFA.
Showing patience.
I hated him
well
on my last career mode.
In the build-up.
Some games he was literally
Montoya.
The difference.
Now he must favour the cross.
If he wasn't on the pitch, I would have beaten him. But unlucky. Go on, Luke. Yes, Luke.
And 30 minutes left for play in this match.
Oh, whoa, Luke. Nice, Luke. Matt, go on then. Go on then, Juan.
He's in with a chance. Will he?
And oh, boys! What matter? Oh. My hand's grown bat on my pants now, lads. I'm not going to lie.
Oh, Derek,
look at
this.
Away from the defender. Pulls away from the keeper. Look at that! Oh, boys!
Well, the goal again.
Oh, how cheeky is that? Oh, that angle's even better. What a goal. Matcher again. It's the most I've ever played him because I can't drop him. He keeps scoring or assisting.
Well, a second
I never rate him
here.
On FIFA, but I cannot drop him. What a goal again.
Scalotto in possession.
Might be controversial, guys, but I'm all about giving you a chance. Bring in Leder. Now we're 2-0 up. And Wan-Bissaka has been quite poor again. I'm going to give Leder a chance. That's what I've been a little bit disappointed with this, this season so far. Because of how poor we've been and how inconsistent we've been, I haven't been able to give the youngsters as much game time as I've wanted to. Like Greenwood's had a lot. Williams has had a lot. Gomez has had quite a bit. Chong, now and again. Garner's been playing recently. Like Bernard. Levitt. Lade. I just haven't been able to quite give him the game time I've wanted to. In my last career mode, we were playing a lot in the Europa League. But because we lost the first two games,
now
I couldn't really afford to play him in the other games then. So.
Stevens. Richards.
But my plan going forward is to always have one or two on the bench. So in games like this where we should be comfortable now, I'd be able to bring him on with like half hour to go or whatever.
Defensive roadblock in the way of that cross.
Because with this career mode, the same as the last, I'm not doing any player training either. So I find by doing player training, you just have unrealistic growth. And like, say I train Greenwood's finishing. Within two or three seasons, his finishing would be better than Harry Kane's, and I just find that so unrealistic. Oh, ref! Can't block me off like that.
So it's going to be a goal kick here.
Here comes Lade.
United will switch things.
Actually, do I want to bring another sub on? 20 minutes to go. I'm so tempted to bring Levitt on. Oh no, I think I will. Yeah, 20 minutes to go, why not? Levitt's coming on as well. I'll keep the centre backs as they are at the moment. So I'm so tempted to bring Bernard on, but then is that too much? Is that Bernard? Got everything I'm looking for in the centre back basically. I think he's 6'3 or 6'4. Fast.
Round
young, if he's only 18, 19. So he ticks all the boxes, I just need to try and give him game time. Pogba pretty much ineffective again. But like I said, I think it's because of where I'm playing him. But I'm, like I said earlier, again, now I haven't got much of a choice at the moment because of a lack of quality in the team.
Neo Mope. Scalotto in
position. My other formation, this is my more Montoya defensive formation with two holding midfielders. But the other formation I play.
Moving into the
shit.
Advanced position.
I know.
Mope.
Lindelof's been an absolute beast. Definitely the best defender United got on FIFA.
What?
Oh! What? Rashford!
Can he take the chance?
Round him. Oh, Mata. Yes! Juan Mata again!
No way for the opposition to contain him. And no wonder.
He's Carter, yeah, I'll be watching that, bro. You watching it? Who do you support, by the way? He's Carter. Drop back about 5 minutes into this game and watch Mata's second goal. That first goal, sorry. Bloody lovely.
Well, let's go back to the goal that was scored.
Thanks for popping in as well, mate. Come on, Mata again.
Well, enjoy the good days as
a coach. Greasy.
It can be a
bloody lovely
ride, I can tell you that.
Man, Mata again, I can't believe it. I cannot drop him. He's undroppable at the moment.
So they restart the game and only one team in.
This is probably the best performance of the season so far, I'd say. Some of the football has been wank worthy.
Eve Bissouma has it.
I'm not even gonna lie. Normally I've done two career modes prior to this. This is my third with United. Because of issues with sliders and stuff. Yes, Slade. Well done. And, on the other two, I've always sold Mata. Second season. Well, at the end of the first.
Dunk on the ball.
But if he carries on like this, I don't think I can sell him.
Has it.
He's obviously done a decline because of his age, but
others to play it too.
If he carries on this form until the end of the season, there's no way I'm selling
Neo
him.
Mope.
I'll bring in a better. I'll bring in a better quality 10 because I need one, especially if I'm in the Champions League. I don't think I'd be able to sell it.
Running room galore for United. Juan Mata, here is Fred.
Lovely.
In full control of the ball here.
Fred.
Really good reading of the game to win possession back.
Nice to see Levitt on the pitch. And Laid.
Richards.
That's what I'm going to try and do now, like I said.
Really fine initial
but
touch.
One or two of those players on the bench.
Montoya.
And if I'm winning comfortably like this, I'll be able to bring him on. Actually, I'm bringing Bernard on now. Only 10 minutes or whatever, but better than nothing. Twan Zabi come off. No, game's in the back, Lindelof. Two young English centre-backs at the back. Well, a back four. English back four. Score prediction. Where's it at? Is it at Chelsea? I think it is it? Yeah, Bruno Fernandes is going to be quality, mate. Really good. Oh, when he came on in the last game with 10 minutes to go, changed the game on his own. But he stands out like the sore thumb because the rest of the squad isn't good enough.
Eve Bissouma has it.
If we can add players like him to the squad next season, then we should be alright.
Montoya.
Well, we'd be better than what we have Montoya been this season, obviously.
Patient, giving it a try. Wonderful block.
Right, put it out the hair. I want Bernard on. I'll do.
And a throw in it's going to be. And United will switch things around.
Yes, Bernard coming on. What a lovely sight. Let's have a look at the team I got out now. De Gea, yeah. Laid, Twan Zabi, Bernard Shaw. Let's say the back English back line. Bernard and Laid, very young. Whoa. Levitt in the midfield. Again, a youngster. Rashford. Looking nice, lads. Looking nice. Jack Grealish, I don't know, mate. I didn't see him going to United, see? It depends who they go for. Obviously, heavily linked with Madison and Grealish. Grealish will be cheaper, and he's on a very good season, so I just see him going to United, see? I can't see him going to Spurs. Chelsea, maybe, but I think if the player himself had a choice, I think he would pick United. And that's not me being biased, that's just the way I see it.
A chance maybe from the wide position. Scalotto in possession.
McTominay. No, McTominay. Luke Shaw.
Drives it in. I just couldn't keep the ball.
Performance of the season, this lads.
Here is
beautiful
Fred.
Goals.
Juan Mata.
Mata has been ridiculous. Oh, hey, ref, come on.
Advantage.
I'm trying to break Mata down. Look, I'm sliding in now with dirty fuckers.
It's Manchester
They've been
United
smashed, and now we're like, oh, let's injure him.
What can they do from here?
Piss off.
And just
ah, Luke,
to
come
keep
on.
The ball and play that time. Often tempting to
oh, do you think they should sign Grealish? He's on my short list, but so like I said earlier in the video, well, I need a number 10 for next season. And I've shortlisted a few. Grealish is on there. Madison's
well,
on there.
The substitute ready, and now they will make the personnel
change. Havertz is on there. But I'll be honest, I'm leaning towards Madison like I normally do, but because Grealish's stats are not great on FIFA. We're not as good as what he is in real life, I don't think. Maybe in the next update, we'll boost him up a bit. Oh, Luke Shaw.
Well, he's got plenty of space on the flank here. Murray. Mopay.
Old Trafford, give a round of applause for today's man of the
Dunk
match.
On the ball.
Number 8, Juan Mata.
Look at Brighton running away. Running away.
Now in possession, Trossard. Yves Bissouma.
What a performance. I've loved this game. Some beautiful
Good
football.
Technique displayed.
Some lovely goals. That second one from Matt and the first from Rashford. Stunning goals. There it.
Relentless
lovely
pressure.
To see the youngsters out there as well. Go on, Martial. Go.
Sure.
No, I don't.
That always looked likely to run through to the keeper.
Again, Martial, I'm not convinced by him. Something about him. What's that? You like Todd Cantwell? Yeah, he's done alright this season. I have shortlisted him, but I have shortlisted him before on my old
Stevens.
Career mode. He had decent stats. I think he's linked with
Jose
Liverpool in real life, isn't he?
And the cross into the middle.
Oh,
and
piss off!
But will it be purely a consolation at this stage
Piss
of the
off.
Proceedings? They haven't been at the
it's
best.
It's like EA, you're like, oh no, they're not having a clean sheet against
well,
us.
I think the players realise what they
and another issue,
coach.
Right?
Lovely sight to see
3-1,
with
he scored in overtime.
Well, Derek,
why would he go running to the manager and hug him when
it's
3-1?
Gives the defenders no chance. Great goal.
I wish EA would sort stuff like that out.
Well, let's take another look at that goal,
why would shall he, we? Why would he go running to the manager after scoring a point, not pointless goal, but
well, it's a tale of four goals in this match now.
I mean, that's just
three,
the usual FIFA bullshit goal.
And the referee blows for full time.
It's not a lot I can do about crosses are coming in and the positioning of my defenders. When it was on the floor, they couldn't pass it through me. They couldn't get through me, so. Yeah, like, oh, we'll whip across in now and make sure his AI-controlled
well,
defenders are nowhere to be seen. What a performance from this guy again.
Well, clearly the difference between the two sides today. Two goals, a really good performance, ran into the channel, did everything right.
Jota.
Absolutely, 9 out of 10.
Never know. Never know. You are Reese, if you haven't seen him yet, I'll show you the goals.
Oh, lovely weighted ball.
Ah,
they might
come on.
In.
Let's see from the start. Oh, he won't go back further. Ah. You can only see half of Fred's stunning pass by there to make it 1-0. Why would they do that? Watch this one from Mata.
He's in with a chance.
Round the keeper. Little dink.
Ah.
Lovely. I take it Matt as man of a match. Of course he is. Levitt with an assist, what? Who did he assist then? Didn't I bring Levitt on when he was 3-0? Oh, I don't know. If he did, fair play, but I don't remember that. I'll have a look at Todd Cantwell now, actually, see what his stats are like. Again, I doubt I'll sign him, but... I'll show you somebody who I'm very interested in, though. Reminds me so much of Tevez, and I used to love Tevez. Oh, not scout another moment. I'll check him on the shortlist anyway and see what he's all about. I said, though, I think he's heavily linked with Liverpool in real life, so... Don't know if I'll go there, but... Somewhere I could very well go is this guy. Lautaro Martinez. Like I said just then, reminds me so much of Tevez. Pace, strength, aggression 86, attack positions 84, finishing 85, heading 82, ball control and dribbling, both 86-84. Guy's a beast. Volley's 80. Very interested in this guy. So like I was saying earlier in the video, with him, there's no confusion. He's a number 9. It's like I said earlier with Rashford and Martial, it's like left 9. With him, it's no argument. He's a number 9, and his stats reflect that. So very interested in Martinez. Yeah, Moise Keane, that's a good shout. Very good shout. I'll check him out now. Thanks for the suggestion, bro. He was on my last shortlist. I just forgot to add... Where is he? Do you spell his name differently to how you normally would? Yeah. No E on the end. Yeah, I'll be scouting him, see what he's all about. Let's see where you're on the... Well, let's see the other results. I wonder what that Man City result was like after. Arsenal 3-1 against Leicester. Ourselves 3-1. Man City 1. So Man City are top now. Oh yeah, Liverpool down to third. How tight it is at the top. Well, top 4. Arsenal only 4 points off the top. 29, 31, 32, 33. Bloody hell. That's where we want to be, but... But then, ourselves, 7th. But only a point behind 5th. But catching top 4 could be really hard. We just need to be so consistent from now until the end of the season. It would be an absolute disaster if come the end of the season, we're outside the top 4 and we've been knocked out of the Europa League. 2 seasons in the Europa League would be a nightmare. But as you can see, still 8 points off 4th. But recent results have been promising. Chelsea 4-0, Spurs 3-0. You like Jack? Jack and Bash? What the hell? Who's that? Hmm. Yeah, I just need to be consistent now. West Ham, Chelsea, Arsenal. I'll check out the calendar now to see how it's looking. Next game will be Sheffield United away, followed by a big game in the Europa League. If I lose or draw that, I think I'm out. So that's a must win. So that's on the Thursday, on the Sunday, Villa. This is going to be a look at this month. Look at December. AC Milan on the Thursday, on the Sunday, Villa. On the Wednesday, Spurs. On the Saturday, Man City. This is going to be really hard because I need to play a strong team there to stay alive in the Europa League. 3 days later, Villa, which is the most winnable game out of the three I got in the week. So again, I need to play quite a strong team there. To beat Spurs and Man City, I need my strongest team and to perform at my best, which is going to be difficult. And then I'll probably have to win this game as well to qualify. And then I got a couple of days later, Everton, Arsenal in the quarterfinal of the Carabao Cup, and then Watford. December could be a nightmare. I just have not got the squad depth to handle this, I don't think. December could make or break this season. So if we lose, say we play Milan and lose, or win even, then we got to play a rotated team against Villa and say we win that, but then lose the next two, and then play that and then lose. And then because we got to play a strong team against Everton, we play a weakened team against Arsenal and lose. We could be out of the Europa League, Carabao Cup, and we could be potentially out of a race for top four. December is huge. Yeah, I think Ancelotti's quality manager, Reece. I do rate the guy. I wouldn't have him at United now. A couple of seasons ago, I would have, but not now. Right, I'm gonna leave it there, boys. I'll be playing. Hang on, let me fast forward to. I'll be stopping the stream, but then pretty much starting another one straight after. So it'll literally be like a minute after this, probably. Remind myself, oh, and then AC Milan, and then we go into the crazy December. Yes, I'm gonna end this one here, guys. Yeah, Reese, I'll be stopping this stream now, and then because I like to do one game per episode, so I've obviously done the Brighton game, so I'll be ending this one, but then I'll be starting pretty much straight up again on another stream for the Sheffield United game, man. So if you want to join me for that, bro. Do feel free. Thanks for watching, and I shall see you in a couple of minutes. Bye.